We met when I was 15 at my cousin's party.
I prepared the guest list for my party and I thought at the last minute, well, maybe I'll invite my little cousin. She might enjoy it. So quite on impulse, I invited Wendy. She was all of 15. Most of my friends must have been 19, 20, 21, I can't remember precisely. And amongst the people at that party at my parents' flat in Daleham Gardens was Peter Phillips.
Peter was, I think, a very sophisticated 19-year-old. And I think one of the first things he said to me was that he would like to see my belly button, which I thought was completely outrageous.
His eyes fell upon this gorgeous young woman, beautiful dark hair, perfect skin, perfect figure. And he became absolutely besotted with her.
And he took me home in his Wolsey, I think it was, took my phone number and said he would contact me. And I waited by the phone all week, and he didn't. And then we met 2 years later at the same cousin's party. He took me home again, and this time he did contact me, but only because his girlfriend at the time was on holiday. So it was an inauspicious start, really.
But eventually he got to see your belly button.
Eventually he got to see my belly button. I made him wait a little while. And then we saw each other intermittently for a few years. Till one day he suggested that it might be a good idea if I looked after his children. And I took that to mean that actually he was quite serious about me. And a year later he formally proposed to me on the train on his way back from going to visit his mother for the first time. And before proposing to me, he very grandly ordered a quarter bottle of champagne. Because I think he was worried that I might say no and didn't want to waste the money on a full bottle. So.
Wise men say.
We got married at Caxton Hall, and Peter had organised a coach and horses as a surprise to collect us from Caxton Hall and take us to the Dorchester. And we travelled en route by Buckingham Palace, where the crowds thought that we were part of the pageantry of London and waved their flags and shouted and cheered us on. So it was a really very thrilling day.
Would it be a sin?
It was a sunny day, everybody was in an amazing mood. My father, who wasn't terribly well at the time, still made a speech, and I was very proud that he'd been asked to speak. I remember a group of us wandering off into Hyde Park and smoking some exotic cigarettes. They're always a bit overrated, but it was part of the fun.
Darling, so it goes. Some things are meant to be. Take my hand. Take my whole life too. For
this is a poem I wrote for Peter for our 30th wedding anniversary, and it's called You Are. My friend, my lover, my foe, my brother, my rival, my equal, my match, my sequel, my sun and my sand, my sight of land, my mum and my dad, my feeling bad, my other half, my autograph, my port in a storm, my feeling warm, the hand in my glove, the place that I love.